And here, most fitly, comes the consideration of the continued absence of him of the dark complexion. Let me pause to observe that the complexion of the man is dark and swarthy. It was no common swarthiness which constituted the sole point of remembrance, both as regards Valence and Madame Deluc. But why is this man absent? Was he murdered by the gang? If so, why are there only traces of the assassinated girl? The scene of the two outrages will naturally be supposed identical. And where is his corpse? The assassins would most probably have disposed of both in the same way. But it may be said that this man lives and is deterred from making himself known through dread of being charged with the murder. This consideration might be supposed to operate upon him now, at this late period, since it has been given in evidence that he was seen with Marie. But it would have no force at the period of the deed. The first impulse of an innocent man would have been to announce the outrage, and to aid in identifying the ruffians. This polity would have suggested he had been seen with the girl, he had crossed the river with her in an open ferry boat. The denouncing of the assassins would have appeared, even to an idiot, the surest and sole means of relieving himself with suspicion. We cannot suppose him, on the night of the fatal Sunday, both innocent himself and incognizant of an outrage committed. Yet only under such circumstances is it possible to imagine that he would have failed, if alive, in the denouncements of the assassin. And what means are ours of attaining the truth? We shall find these means multiplying and gathering distinctness as we proceed. Let us sift to the bottom this affair of the first elopement. Let us know the full history of the officer, with his present circumstances, and his whereabouts at the precise period of the murder. Let us carefully compare with each other the various communications sent to the evening paper, in which the object was to inculpate a gang. This done, let us compare these communications, both as regards style and manuscript, with those sent to the morning paper at a previous period, and insisting so vehemently upon the guilt of Manet.